Hi everyone, this is Angel.
And I'm Jeremy.
Today's topic is 换钱.
Getting change. Okay, I don't know about you, but she was pretty lucky that she didn't have to buy anything in that store to get the change.
Yeah, it's really, maybe because she's beautiful or, the shopkeeper is quite kind.
Could be. Yeah. So fairly unusual then.
So let's review the dialogue.
Okay.
不好意思，我没有零钱可以找你。
I'm very sorry, I don't have any change to give you.
那怎么办?
Then what should we do?
你去那家店问一下,看能不能换点零钱。
Go into that shop and ask to see if they can change some money.
好的,您稍等一下。
Okay, please wait a sec.
师傅,能换一下零钱吗?
Sir, can you change some money?
没问题,换多少?
No problem. How much would you like to change?
把这张一百块的换成一张五十块的，四张十块的，还有十个一块的硬币。
Change this 100 yuan note into one 50 yuan note, four 10 yuan notes, and 10 1 yuan coins.
好了，您数数。
There you go, you count it.
麻烦您了，谢谢。
Thanks for your troubles.
Yes, lots of troubles to the shopkeeper.
Yeah.
Okay, let's see the language points.
Okay.
The first one, 乘。
乘。
把这张一百块的换成一张五十块的，四张十块的，还有十个一块的硬币。
And now this is a verb complement.
Yes.
And it means to become.
Mm.
Okay. So it goes straight after the verb. And can we have an example sentence?
Okay. 请你把汉语翻译成英文。
Okay.Can you please translate this Chinese into English?
Yes.
Okay, so the into,
成,
成, came right after the word for translate.
翻译, yes.
翻译,
yes.
So 翻译成, that's pretty much how it happens. You put the verb and then you follow it with 成 to say turned into.
Yeah, it's a verb complement.
Yes, can we have another example?
Okay, 雪化成水了。
Okay.The snow thawed and became water.
Yes, became.
Okay, so the verb there was...
化.
Yes, 化. And we placed 成 after it to say became. So thawed and then became water.
Yes.
Okay, what's the second language point?
That is 看.
看.
不好意思,我没有零钱可以找你。
那怎么办?
你去那家店问一下,看能不能换点零钱。
Now this is a word we've all learned before, which means to see or to look. But, like English, it has a different sort of meaning, which is more like to look into or to investigate something.
Yes.
Can we have an example?
Okay. 先做几天看。
Okay, so it's, let's do it for a few days and see what will happen.
Yes.
So, it's not let's do it for a few days and see, it's and to see
to
what will happen, to investigate what will happen if we leave it for a few days or if we do something for a few days.
Yes.
Can we have one more example?
Okay, look at, 我感冒了。
I'm sick.
Yeah. 吃点药,看行不行。
Eat some medicine and see if you get better, or take some medicine and see if you get better.
Yes.
So that 看 there is not to look good, not to look and see, it's to investigate whether or not you'll get better. It's to wait and see.
Yes, and try to have some medicine.
Mm.
Mm. Okay, let's see the tips.
Okay, and in today's tips, we've got a couple. First of all, we want to look at 好了 and 好的.
Mm.
Now, they sound fairly similar, but 好了
好了 means, competition. It means a down.
It indicates completion because of that 了.
Yes.
Right. So it's sort of like done already or enough.
Yes.
Okay. Whereas 好的 is just a general word for okay.
Yeah, okay.
Okay, can we have just an example?
Okay. 好了可以走了。
Right, done, ready, let's go. One more for 好的。
嗯，能帮我拿一下吗？
Can you help me to get it?
好的。
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, 好的.
好的.
That's pretty self-explanatory, I think.
Yes.
Now, we have another language tip.
Yeah.
And it relates to money, which has been our topic today.
That is, 快元和人民币.
Right. And this is something that foreigners find very perplexing when they come to China. What's the difference?
Actually, kuai, you can be here, take it as a very colloquial way to say money. I mean, renminbi or yuan. It means bucks.
Okay, so kuai is like bucks. So if I was talking with a few buddies, having a drink, how much does it cost? 3 bucks. So you say san kuai. Right. But if you're in a more formal situation, you might say buying a house. You'd say this cost me $100,000. You wouldn't say you could use yuan maybe in that instance.
You should be.
Okay.
Yeah, that is 10万元.
Okay. Now, there's one more word which you mentioned, which was RMB or renminbi or
RMB or renminbi. Yeah, the same.
And that is
it's the name of currency.
Okay, so it's the official name of the Chinese currency.
Yes.
And what does it translate to roughly? Something
like a people's currency.
The people's currency.
Yes.
So renminbi.
People, renmin. Currency, B.
Right. Okay. Well, that clears things up for us.
Yes, and also, I mean, RMB is an abbreviation of the pinyin pronunciation.
RMB. RMB.
Yes.
Simple.
Yeah, that's it.
Okay, well, that's it for today. So,
yes.
Thanks for joining us, and we'll see you next time at MandarinTube.com.
Yeah, your Chinese learning channel.
Bye.
Okay, bye. And when she lets me slip away.